Hey, Jordan Bench here, jordanbench.com. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to set goals. So the reason why I'm talking about this is because this is something that I used to struggle with like big time. I was not a goal setter. I was someone who had a hard time like getting things done, achieving things. I was lazy, procrastinator, you name it. I was someone who just like went with the flow. So since I've done or started an online business, I have really learned to become laser focused, to be someone who's been driven to get things done. And I've really had to learn how to learn not to be a procrastinator. Now, for some people, like just getting things done comes easy to them. To me, it was really hard because I got so sidetracked from, you know, so many different things. And it was just really hard for me to actually sit down and accomplish some stuff. So this video is all about how to set goals. So I'm going to share with you some of like my experience on how I was able to achieve goals, how I was able to, you know, think of it in terms of how do we actually get from point A to point B. So this is what you want to do. When you first like decide that you want to achieve something, you typically need to start very broad and, you know, start at a high level. Think of like a 30,000 foot view, like as if you're in an airplane and you're looking down and you're really trying to see the big picture of everything. All right. So that's where you're going to start. Now, this can be, say, 3 months out, 6 months out, a year, 2 years, 3 years, you know, it's just far out of what something you want to achieve or something that you want to do. So you start off by thinking big picture. Okay. And then what you do is you narrow that down in to even a smaller view. So maybe instead of being a 30,000 foot view, now you're down at the, you know, 10,000 foot view. And you've got a closer look down at the picture. So then what you want to do is once you have, you know, the highest level and then you have like the mid level, then you want to look even further down to where maybe now you're like, say, in a tree 30 feet down and you're looking right there on the specific thing. So once you kind of can visualize the different levels in which you're looking at this, then you can then develop a game plan. So first, like think it's, let's say you're thinking 6 months out from now or even 3 months out from now as your big picture. Then when you zoom in, you're gonna say, okay, well, what do I need to achieve within the next month so that I can get to my goal by 3 months? Then what you wanna do is say, okay, for me to get to my goal, in a month from now, what do I need to be doing on a daily and weekly basis so that I can get to my 1 month goal, which is going to get me then to the 3 month goal. So really it just comes down to breaking down your goals into smaller goals and then into like mini goals. So you have a very big goal and then you break it down to a small goal and then you break it down to little mini goals. And as you do those mini goals, you'll end up getting to the place to where you end up achieving the small goal. And then the small goal, you do enough of those, you'll achieve the larger goal. You'll achieve the big picture of things. So right now, I understand I am kind of speaking really broad. Right now, I'm not really giving you specifics. So let me give you an example. In terms of like me wanting to do an online business. So I wanted to do an online business. I was someone within my wife and I, our current business that we have, I was someone who was behind the scenes. I did a lot of the technical stuff. I tried to figure out like a lot of the logistics of what we were trying to do. And she was someone who was in front of the camera. She was communicating with the women in her program. We have like an online health and fitness business, and it's more specifically like a online workout program. So I was behind the scenes in that, and she was the one that was in all the videos, did all the training, everything else. So people knew her. I was behind the scenes. They didn't really know who I was. And for me, it kind of got to the point to where I felt like I just wasn't contributing in the way that I should. So I decided to do an online business for myself. So the idea was, okay, well, for me to do this, for me to start my own business, I'm going to have to start putting myself on camera. I'm going to have to start putting myself out there. So whether that's emails, blog posts, whether that was YouTube videos or even, say, podcasts, I had to do something to get myself out there. So I chose to do YouTube videos. So I knew that I had to do YouTube videos because that was the means in which people could get to know who I am. And then if they can, from my videos, decide, okay, you know what, this dude over here, you know, I don't really like him too much. He's cocky, arrogant, whatever, right? Hopefully you don't think that. But that's kind of the idea, is like people can then form opinions about me based on the way that I act or the content that I'm giving out, because really my heart is to give out the best content that I can from the information that I know, that I can share the most, that I can help you out the best that I can. And by doing that, hopefully what happens is people then begin to like me and they begin to trust me and they begin to value my opinion on things. So really, when it comes to like doing business or anything, that's really how you do business, is people like align with you and your values and your beliefs or what you're about. And then there's someone who eventually down the road, at some point, if you recommend things or you put something out, then they'll buy from you. So I knew for me to start a business, I had to do YouTube videos. So that was like my big goal, is to start a business. And then I said, okay, my small goal is I need to do a YouTube channel. I need to start doing videos. So then I set a mini goal. My mini goal was for me to do a video a day. Do a video a day. And by me doing that, I would begin to put out content enough to where hopefully over time, YouTube will begin to show my videos to enough people, and then I'll be able to gain traction from that. So that was for me in a way for me to start my online business. And so I did start a website, and I'm gonna do a whole lot more with it, and I have a lot more ideas of what I'm gonna do, but that was just a way for me to get started. So I thought big picture, and then I brought it down, and then I brought it down again into daily actionable steps, or like weekly actionable steps. So really that's what you wanna do, is start, like I said, you do these little steps that will accumulate over time. Think about someone who wants to lose weight. So if someone says, I want to lose weight, to me, that's not really good enough. You have to get specific, you have to get actionable. So long term, what are you looking to do long term? Okay, well, you know, I want to lose 60 pounds. Okay, so what's a good time frame to do this? All right, so you want to lose 60 pounds by next year, or 60 pounds in 6 months. Okay, so that's the big picture. So let's bring it down. What's the small goal? All right, so to lose 60 pounds in that time, what do we need to do? 60 pounds in 6 months? Okay, let's shoot for 10 pounds a month. So each month we're trying to lose 10 pounds. Now, if we don't hit 10 pounds, it's not a big deal, because I know some months, maybe you lose 12, maybe you lose 14, other months, maybe you lose 8, maybe you lose 6, I don't know, I'm just saying. So, but the goal is that you're trying to lose 10 pounds a month leading up to the 6 months. Okay, so then from there, it's like, okay, so what do I need to be doing on a daily and weekly basis to get to that point? Okay, so maybe it's like, you just gotta get in the gym. Just start getting in the gym just so you're active. So on a daily basis, maybe you're in the gym doing something. Don't know what it is, but maybe you're doing something, right? Or maybe it's you're just starting to drink, you're drinking enough water for your body weight on a daily basis. Or maybe it's you're starting to get, you're increasing your protein on a daily basis because you're under in protein. So on a daily basis, you're getting enough protein in. Or maybe it's you're eating enough healthy fats in. Me and my wife will teach a lot, like within her business, that you're balanced with your nutrition. And we call it like the PFF breakfast. And with that, having like a PFF, I don't want to say breakfast, but it's more so like a daily guideline of how you should be eating, which is protein, carbs, I should say fibers, carbs, and healthy fats. You want to have like a balance of those things. And if you can do that, have a balance of those foods, you're not like way out of proportion on any of them. It's all moderate, and it's all good. It's all healthy. Then you're going to start seeing some weight loss over time. So it's like setting up little mini goals that will lead to those smaller goals. And then if you do that enough, it's going to lead to the big goal. So really that's what I'm referring to, is you have to start on the big term, drop it down to the small, and then go to the mini. So hopefully that makes sense. Hopefully I gave you a good enough analogy of how this can work in your life, and what you can do on how you can set a goal and how to achieve it. Really, it doesn't really matter what you're trying to achieve. It's just that you set a big goal for yourself, and then you set little mini goals, actionable, to get it done. So anyways, I hope you like this video. I hope this likes this kind of content. If you do, give it a like, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions for me or any video suggestions, it can be related to business, it can be related to health, or even faith and spirituality. I'm a Christian, I'm a believer, and I'm very passionate about that. And I really want to see other believers get strengthened and grow up into Christ. And I'm also very passionate about business and health. So if you have any questions, or if you have any video suggestions on those topics, go ahead and comment those below. And I will see you in the next video.